Sayyeda Zainab alayhi salam, in her teens, while she got married, as you know, she got married to Abdullah bin Ja'far, the son of her uncle, Ja'far al-Tayyar. Abdullah, she married him. She had a couple of kids early, then they had a pause, then they had a couple of kids later on, which is something completely natural. Some families decide to have children very early and then pause and then later on. But that did not stop her. Was she active in the community? Subhanallah, what activity? Monday, tafsir of the Quran. Tuesday, tajweed of the Quran. Allahu Akbar. Sometimes you could do tafsir of the Quran. Yes, you explain the meanings of the verses of the Quran. On Tuesday, let's do recital of the Holy Quran. Yes. There are some who cannot read Arabic in our community. There are some lovers of Ahlulbayt. If you sit him with the Quran now, I guarantee you, cannot read Arabic. If you cannot, then there's no embarrassment taking lessons. Go and take lessons. Go and sit supervised. That Quran will speak on the Day of Judgment. Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam would tell the woman of Medina, where are all of you? How many of you want to read tafsir of the Quran? You want to know the meanings of the verses? Monday, come home. Tuesday, how many of you want to do tajweed of the Quran? You want to see how to recite beautifully the Quran? Come home. Wednesday, how many of you want to learn about the aqaid of Al Muhammad? What is our beliefs? How do we explain tawheed? How do we explain nubuwa? How do we explain imama? Come home. Thursday, how many of you want to learn about the laws of the religion of Islam? Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam have something unique. If you cannot reach the imam of their time, they say to you, go to the woman, for they are as learned as those imams with the knowledge that the imams have given them. I've seen this on a number of occasions. I remember when that person came to visit Imam al-Askari one day. When he came to visit Imam al-Askari, who was there? Sayyida Hakima was there, the daughter of Imam al-Jawad. Yes, you know, all of them are buried in Samarra. Imam al-Hadi, Imam al-Askari, Sayyida Hakima, Sayyida Narjis, they're all buried in Samarra. When that person, Ahmed bin Ibrahim, came, Imam al-Askari was busy. Subhanallah! Sayyida Hakima says, if Imam al-Askari cannot answer your question, then go to the wife of Imam al-Askari, she'll provide you with the answer. Or go to the daughter of Imam al-Askari, she'll provide you with the answer. Sayyida Zainab, Monday, Quran tafsir. But Sayyida, your mom got killed in front of you behind that door. Surely you'd attack the world. Surely you'd blame this world. Surely you'd say, why am I always the one under test? Not Zainab. Zainab shows you, you know what? You can overcome this adversity. Don't let people come and tell you you should be depressed, you should be suicidal, you should blame everyone. No, 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 you will be victorious. Monday, Quran tafsir. Tuesday, tajweed. Wednesday, aqaid. Thursday, let's study law. Let's study the laws of Islam. What is it? Do you have questions about your cleanliness? Ask me. Do you have questions about domestic issues, marriage issues, legal issues of salah and sawm and hajj? Come and ask me. Did her husband, Abdullah bin Ja'far, say, Zainab, why are you giving this knowledge away? I'm your husband. I want more time from you. On the contrary, he was honored to have Zainab alongside him. Yes? On the contrary, he said, if my wife is doing tabligh of the message of her grandfather, then I am honored to be living in such a house, because rizq and blessings is being showered on that household. Today it's a shame when there are husbands, when their wives want to go to the mosque. Why are you always going to the mosque? When their wives want to serve the community, why are you serving the community so much? When their wives want to go on Monday nights or Wednesday nights to go and learn knowledge, why always going to gain knowledge? That why is not the example of Al Muhammad. Naturally, there is a balance that is required in the house. But Abdullah bin Ja'far, never once in his life did he turn around to Sayyida Zainab and say to her, why? On the contrary, he wanted Sayyida Zainab to continue teaching as much as she could. When her father left Medina to go to Kufa, Imam Ali, as you know, when he became Khalifa, he moved to Kufa, Sayyida Zainab went with him. Abdullah bin Ja'far could have turned around and said, why are we so close to your father? I don't want to be close to the in-laws. But what in-law is there better than Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam? Yes, they used to live right next to Masjid Kufa. Imam Ali would give lessons in the mosque. Sayyida Zainab would give lessons in her house. Zinat Abiha Zainab. The adornment of her father. And that's why he had such a soft spot for her, that when he was struck on the 19th of Ramadan, look at the softness of Ali. Look at the softness. On the 19th of Ramadan, when he was struck, the moment he got struck, as he's leaving the Musalla area, as he's leaving, he's limping, because the injury was such a deep injury. As he was leaving, he was limping. The moment he gets to the door of Masjid al-Kufa, when you leave Masjid al-Kufa, you take a left, is Imam Ali's house. Those of you being Ziyara would have seen it. The moment he took the left, he said, Hassan, Hussein, let your father stand straight. They said, Dad, but you're injured. He said, let me stand straight. Why, Dad? He said, I see Zainab at the door. I don't want her to know I'm injured. I've already seen her heart break when she was younger. I want her to remain happy when she sees me. The moment he enters the house, she breaks down. She cannot bear because, you know, if you were an orphan at six, your dad is everything to you. Everything. Your mom's not there anymore. Your dad is everything to you. She breaks down and subhanallah, Amir al-Mu'mineen's 1 weak spot in his life. And you can't even call it weak in our general terminology. But his 1 weak spot in his life, Zainab and Kulthum. Yes? Even when he was dying, the tears were flowing from Imam Hassan, Imam Hussein. He told them, Hassan, Hussein, please be patient. I beg you, be patient. The moment he sees Zainab cry, he cannot stop crying. Yes? He said, I cannot bear to see Zainab cry. Why? Because for him, Zainab was a reflection of him in every act of his. In his salah, in his voice, in his eloquence. And he knew that she was bestowed with a knowledge which was unique. Subhanallah, the knowledge of Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam. Because today, whenever I hear people praising Sayyidah Zainab, you know why they say she's great? She's Imam Ali's daughter. No. She's Fatima Zahra's daughter. That's why she's great. No. She's Rasulullah's granddaughter. That's why she's great. No. Zainab is Zainab. Simple. We do not make people great by association. We make people great by merit in the school of Ahlulbayt. I don't care. Abu Lahab is the uncle of Muhammad. He's not great in my eyes. I don't care if he's the uncle of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, his family. Yes? Ahlulbayt, alayhi salam, your greatness is on your merit. When someone today says Zainab's great because Zainab is the daughter of Imam Ali, no. Zainab's great because she's the daughter of Fatima Zahra, no. Zainab is Zainab. She's great by her own merit. You know what Imam Zain al-Abidin said about her knowledge? Wallah, this line shakes you when you hear this line, yes? Amma Zainab, anti alima ghair mu'allama, wa fahima ghair mufahama. My auntie Zainab, it should suffice you that you are learned without being taught by anyone. And you have understanding without being trained by anyone. Subhanallah. Do you know what Imam Zain al-Abidin is saying over here? This is a proof that Sayyida Zainab alayhi salam reached a level of asma. They call it asma al-sughra. Yes? The minor infallibility. You know what that is? Because of her constant obedience to Allah, Allah showered a grace upon her. Not just the grace to protect her from sin, like her mother Fatima was protected, but a second grace. What was that second grace? Even the angels would come and communicate with Zainab alayhi salam. Yes? Imam Zain al-Abidin, in this line, Amma Zainab, my auntie Zainab, anti alima ghair mu'allama, you are learned without being taught by anyone. Wa anti fahima ghair mufahama. And you have understanding without anyone training you to have that understanding. You know, Ibn Hajar, the famous scholar of Ahl Sunnah, renowned scholar. You know what he describes Sayyida Zainab as in those years before Karbala? He says, you know what Zainab is? Al-aqilatul aqilatul labibatul jazla. Allahu Akbar, the Arabic which he uses. This is not normal words they're using. Al-aqila, al-aqila, al-labiba, al-jazla. Ya Allah, go to the books of the dictionaries. Look at the 4 words he's used to describe Zainab. Aqila. What's aqila? Aqila refers to what? You have aql and you have jahl. You have the intellect and you have ignorance. He says you are the epitome of intellect. Yes? Al-aqila, al-aqila. You are the intellectual, the honorable. Al-labiba, al-jazla. You are the one who has depths of understanding, but with a dignity that nobody can match. Subhanallah. Normally, when someone's intellectual, their dignity leaves a lot to be desired. Sometimes they're arrogant with that intellectuality. They've received their degrees, they've gone to the best universities. It's very rare for you to find a balance of intellect and dignity. Ibn Hajar says, you know what Zainab is? Zainab is al-aqilatu al-aqila, al-labib al-jazla. No woman has received 4 accolades in one sentence like Zainab received in that moment. In other words, you know what he was saying? When you look for al-insan al-kamil, the perfect human being, just stare at the face of Zainab, you have perfection in front of you.